Bunny, and it is time for everybody's favorite day of the week, and that is the day when we ask ourselves, does this thing really work? And today, we are going to be testing out the highly requested yes. And I've already ravaged the packaging, so there's actually no device currently in here. Here is the yes, which is kind of a blatant, like, slap in the face, I think, to the no-no, because the yes is a hair-removing system, and it's supposed to be very much like the no-no. If you've seen the actual infomercial, the commercials are almost identical. You get a bunch of ladies, like, out in public, maybe like a shopping mall, outdoor mall, something like that, and they give them this miraculous little device, and they glide it along some source of hair on their body, and then the hair is miraculously removed. There's really not a whole lot of instructions that go with this thing. If you guys remember the no-no that I think I did, like, way earlier this year, there were a lot of instructions and a lot of reviews, a lot of things that came with that device, but this is literally all that you get with the yes. Kind of like the no-no, they say, like, if you touch it, oh, I forgot to turn it on, that might help. First of all, this thing takes 2.5 hours to charge up properly the first time. Ooh, there we go. It does have, like, glowing, blinking, flashing. I think it's not technically a laser, but some kind of lights, and, oh, it, like, vibrates. It says that it's Sensa light technology. I'm not 100% sure what that means. This comes with 2 different blade heads, which I did not know, and I did a week's worth of preparation for using this device by not shaving my legs. Hairy legs! Little did I know, though, that it doesn't say anything in the instructions about not shaving or the hair has to be a certain length. Once again, for the no-no, it was like that. You had to have, like, I don't know, like, ridiculously long hair on your body before you could make it work. This thing, though, kind of reminds me of a precision trimmer, like the one that I use to kind of clean up my eyebrows really quick sometimes, or just, like, remove other facial hairs with. This kind of has, like, longer little, like, grooves. It looks more like a traditional shaving device, like, you know, clippers that people use to, like, buzz their hair really short. And then it also has this tool, which you're supposed to use for stubble or very short hairs. And this looks like an epilator, like those kind of, like, cheese grater type things. So many disgusting analogies. You do have to change and replace the heads. I guess you could buy extra replacement blades online. Like I was saying, not a whole hill of beans of information here. You're supposed to be able to use this absolutely anywhere. Chins, sideburns, underarms, knees, face, calf, thigh. Basically anywhere that you have unwanted hair, you can use this device. But unlike the no-no, I don't think it's supposed to be like a permanent solution to removing the hairs. It's just like a temporary shaving device. This thing is $40, so I'm about to see how effective it is at shaving the legs. I guess if it really works, it would be easy, you know, like if you're just running out of the house and you decide, oh, I'm not gonna wear pants today, I'm gonna wear a dress, and you, like, didn't wanna have, like, hairy legs, but you didn't have time to take a shower before you go out. I don't know. We shall see. I'm gonna try and move the camera so that you guys can see a nice up-close shot of my weird, disturbing, hairy legs. I'm not even sure if you can see the hairs on my legs. Even when my leg hair gets on the longer side, it's still pretty lightly colored, so it's just all these invisible annoying hairs that you can't see. I'm just gonna see how this works. You're supposed to go at a 45 degree angle with this trimmer, and in the infomercial they show people moving at a very fast pace. I'm probably going slower than what they show, so I'm gonna try and gain a little bit of speed here. So far, I'm not seeing that much of a difference. It is trimming the hairs, But it's not removing them, really. I can still see tiny little black hairs everywhere. Are you guys seeing this? Are y'all able to see this at all? That's the patch that I just went over. Right there. It's not painful at all, so that's a bonus. I definitely think, once again, if it was a situation where you were just trying to, like, touch up, shave an area, and you were running out of the house, it definitely probably trims the hairs short enough that from a long distance, if nobody was touching your legs, you could probably totally get away with it. You're just supposed to push with your thumbs. And it pops off like that. Since now I have a little patch of stubble on my legs, we can go ahead and use this stubble blade really quick and see if that, like, totally removes that patch of hair off of my legs. So the trimmer blade, you're supposed to hold at a 45 degree angle when you're removing the hairs, but this, like, stubble blade, you're supposed to hold directly up and down. And I don't know about you guys, but I have tried, like, epilator hair removal devices before that were supposed to be painless. I have never had an epilator that works painlessly. Maybe if you do, oh my goodness. I know traditionally epilators, though, like, remove the hair for a longer period of time. So maybe if you use this head, it will kind of, like, remove the hair more than just trim it or shave it away. Here is the same area where the hair is now at stubble length. So I'm gonna hold this directly up and down. Wow, I'm surprised. This is still not painful at all. Using this attachment slightly changed my mind about the gimmickiness of this device. Using this stubble removal blade, I think that this thing is actually surprisingly highly effective. Using this removal head, it literally totally did remove all of the hair off of my leg, and my legs feel surprisingly smooth in that patch. And honestly, I shave my legs a lot, and my skills of leg shaving over the years has not tremendously improved. I'm kind of clumsy. I nick myself a lot, especially in the situation I described before, like if I'm trying to run out of the house and just shave really super quick. So definitely, if you have just a little bit of stubble and you want to remove it, I really think that this device could totally work, and for the first time I can say it is totally painless. It didn't hurt at all. I didn't even feel like a slight tingling, weird, pulling, burning sensation at all. The only thing that is kind of gimmicky, besides the name sounding extremely like another hair removal device already on the market, is the blue light. Or it's not even blue, it's like a clear light, but since it's shining through the purple color, it makes it look like a blue light. But since this isn't a laser, and once again, I don't think it's supposed to have, like, permanent, long-lasting shaving effects, I'm kind of just like, why is it glowing? That seems a little pointless. I'm curious to hear you guys' opinions about this. I honestly can say I think it does really work. I think it is much more effective, once again, if you use it on shorter, stubbly hairs than if you use the trimmer device. The price is kind of expensive, I think, personally. I don't know. What do you guys feel about the $40 price tag? Also, I will try and list in the frame of the video. I'm gonna try and look and research and see how much the replacement heads cost and where you can get them from. I found this at Bed Bath & Beyond, and they only had the device, not any of the replacement heads, so I've not seen them before. I don't have any information about that, or how often you would need to replace them. As always, I am really interested in hearing you guys' opinions. Do you have this? Are you gonna buy this? Are you gonna try this? What do you think about 40 bucks for it? Also, comment down below and let me know for next week's Does This Thing Really Work? Or the next couple weeks that I do, what device that you would like for me to try? Or even if you would like me to retry one that I've done and maybe messed up in the past, comment down below and let me know, and I will gladly do it. If you're not already and you'd like to be, hit that button down below, subscribe, become a member of the Swamp Family, and give an alligator its wings. Also, if you want, you can like me on Facebook, facebook.com/graveyardgirl, or you can follow me on Twitter, Tumblr, or Instagram at graveyardgirl, same way it's spelled here. I love you guys so, so much, and I will see y'all tomorrow. Bye!